Hello and welcome to the Ufilms Oscars Rundown. I'm Amy and today I'm going to be talking about some of my favourite Best Picture winners so far. At number 8 we have Crash. It won Best Picture in 2006 and tells the stories of different people living in LA. The film's very clever in the way that all the stories are interwoven and everyone's linked together. It also does a brilliant job at highlighting the racial tensions that were felt at the time. And it still feels relevant today, linking into the Black Lives Matter campaign. Crash manages to show the racism in a variety of ways. There's scenes like this one that are very tense to show the seriousness of the situation.
All right, both of you turn around, put your hands on top of your head and interlock your fingers.
No, wait a minute. We're only a block
hands
away from our
hands on your head
house.
And interlock your fingers.
That's
hands
not
on
even
your
necessary.
Head, interlock your fingers.
Look, here I'm a go. Television director. Wait! Me and my wife are just coming home from an award show.
Calm down.
Calm down.
Nothing wrong.
Put your hands on top of your head, ma'am.
Will you just do what he says?
While scenes like this are quite comedic to show the irony of the situation.
We didn't get any coffee that you didn't want and I didn't order, and that's evidence of racial discrimination. Did you notice that our waitress was black?
And black women don't think in stereotypes? You tell me something, man. When was the last time you met one who didn't think she knew everything about your little lazy ass before you even opened your mouth, huh? That waitress sized us up in 2 seconds. We're black and black people don't tip. So she wasn't gonna waste her time? Now somebody like that, nothing you could do to change their mind.
So, how much is you leaving?
You expect me to pay for that kind of service?
At number 7 is Birdman. This is one of the more recent Oscar-winning films. It won Best Picture in 2015, along with Best Original Screenplay, Best Director, and Best Cinematography. The film's about a washed-up actor who's living in the shadow of the superhero that he used to play. The film's really clever because it's designed to look like it's all one long shot. The scenes are all well choreographed so that everything happens at the exact right moment. And the editing is brilliant because you can't tell where there actually is a cut and where there isn't. The film only took 2 months to film and another 2 weeks to edit, which is surprising considering how complex it all is. At number 6 we have Rain Man. This is a classic 80s film about a man called Raymond who's an autistic savant. Before the film's release, not many people knew what autism was, so the film's success really helped to bring awareness of the condition. The film won Best Picture in 1988, and Dustin Hoffman also won Best Actor for his performance as Rain Man.
Oh, Vern, beat your hand. Of course, these people are going to be here all day, Vern.
This is an unannounced visit, Vern. This is definitely not a weekend visit, Vern.
The film does a brilliant job at showing the special relationship that Raymond has with his brother, and how it changes over time. At number 5, we have Schindler's List. Although this is a very difficult film to watch, it's something that everybody should watch at least once. It tells the story of how Oskar Schindler managed to save 1,200 Jewish people from the Nazis in World War II. The film is in black and white, and although I normally don't like black and white films, Schindler's List is really the exception. The lack of colour all the way through the film really highlights the one scene that does have colour. The camera follows a little girl in a red coat as she walks around the ghetto alone, with no parents or adults to look after her. It's a very emotional scene and really puts things into perspective. The film won an incredible 7 Oscars in 1994, including Best Picture, Best Director, Best Original Score, and Best Set Design. In 4th place is The French Connection. This film is quite slow in the beginning, it can be difficult to follow, but it's really worth sticking with it. The story is based on real events, and follows 2 New York cops as they try to catch a French businessman smuggling drugs into the country. The film was groundbreaking for its time, with the special effects makeup helping to create a more gory scene than what the audiences were used to in 1971. The camera work was also new and creative, with one of the most memorable shots being filmed from the front bumper of a car. To help show the speed of the car even more, they also set the camera to only film 18 frames per second, rather than the usual 24. The chase sequences throughout the film are very clever and creative. In particular, the subway scene is very effective at building tension and keeping the audience on the edge of their seats. Forrest Gump comes in 3rd place, winning Best Picture in 1995. The film tells the heartwarming journey of Forrest's life from being a young boy growing up in the 1950s all the way up until the present day. Although Forrest has a low IQ, his life has been full of adventures because of his love of running. The film is also quite comical in the way that he ends up in certain situations completely by accident, and how unimpressed he is at meeting several different presidents. The storytelling of the film is also really unique, as Forrest actually narrates his own life by telling it to complete strangers who are all just waiting for a bus.
I bought her a new hat with little flowers on it. And that's all I have to say about that.
The film won a total of 6 Oscars, including Best Actor for Tom Hanks, Best Adapted Screenplay, and Best Director. In second place is Spotlight, which won Best Picture in 2016. It tells the story of how journalists at the Boston Globe uncovered the scandal of child molestation within the Catholic Church. Before watching the film, I didn't know that much about the scandal, but the film does a brilliant job at really opening your eyes and showing you the true extent of the problem. From watching the film, you can really see the amount of pressure that was put on the journalists not to tell the story. A lot of people knew that something was going on, but they didn't want to stand up and say anything.
You know, people need the church more than ever right now. You know, you can feel it. And the Cardinal, he might not be perfect. But we can't throw out all the good he's doing over a few bad apples.
This is how it happens, isn't it, Pete?
What's that?
Guy leans on a guy, and suddenly the whole town just looks the other way.
The film really does a great job of showing you how they overcame that and how they actually managed to uncover what was happening. And the top spot goes to The Godfather. The film shows Michael Corleone's rise to the top of his father's crime family. The baptism scene in particular is one of the best parts of the film. The shots of people being assassinated while Michael is given his vows as Godfather is very powerful and very clever, as it shows the contrast of good and evil really well.
I do renounce him.
This was really a defining film about gangsters. Before, films had always focused on the mafia from an outsider's perspective, whereas this film was the first to show the inner workings of a crime family. The Godfather won Best Picture in 1973, and is the only film to have its sequel win the award too. The film's massive success also helped pave the way for films like Goodfellas and Reservoir Dogs to follow in later years. And those are my favourite Best Picture films. Which films would make your list? Let us know in the comments below, and tune in tomorrow for Callum and Joe's prediction show.